Let us now study reflecting telescope, which is also an astronomical telescope. We already discussed the astronomical telescope, which is of refracting type. And here you can see this was a refracting telescope we already studied, in which from distant object on objective lens, so when light rays are incident, first intermediate image is obtained at a distance equal to the focal length of objective. And from this point, whichever image is produced, it will act as the image for the eyepiece lens. And finally, the image is produced by the eyepiece for the observer. So this distance, we have discussed that it can be UE for the final image to be produced at the near point of the eye, or it can be FE if a final image is produced at infinity for the relaxed state of observer's eye. Here you can see this is the internal structure of a reflecting type telescope, in which the direct light rays which are coming from distant object are allowed to incident on a concave mirror, which is considered as the objective, or the objective lens is replaced by a converging mirror, which converges light rays at a point, and before converging, a plane mirror is placed over here, which reflects the light rays. And finally, an image is produced at an optical distance. This distance, L-shaped distance, can be considered as the focal length of this objective mirror. And finally, this image will be seen by an observer through the eyepiece. And in this situation here, you can see the direction of light rays can also be changed by placing eyepiece over here at right angle to it if the plane mirror is placed at 45 degrees to the incident direction of light. And the optical setup is exactly similar to this, but the only difference is here when astronomical objects are seen which are very far away, the intensity of light rays is very small, and in such situation the aperture of the tube of a reflecting telescope is kept very large so that a good amount of light can incident on the objective mirror, and the image produced will be relatively bright compared to a reflecting telescope. And this telescope will have similar magnifying power, and here also this eyepiece distance can be adjusted as UE and FE for the final image at near point of eye or at infinity for its relaxed state. And here another advantage of using this reflection type telescope or objective mirror is this will be relatively free from chromatic aberrations which are there in case of refracting telescope for due to the use of two lenses. So here, due to the use of this mirror, the chromatic aberrations are also decreased.